There's been so many things that's held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our show together, we're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore.
Good afternoon, RHS. I'm Harmony Bedekian.
And I'm Macy Kryaski.
The 2022 fall sports season has come to an end, with a variety of results from league champs to teams that struggled a little harder.
No matter what the team's results ended up being, these athletes spent countless hours devoting time to the games they enjoyed.
We want to highlight those athletes, starting with football.
Hi guys, I'm Harmony Bedekian, and I'm here with Tyler Curdy and Gordo Gonzalez, who are our football seniors this year, along with a few other kids. So guys, tell me about your season, and how would you sum it up?
Did not go as expected, but had fun.
It was a little bit of both. It went both ways. We had fun, and then it goes as we planned. Injuries here and there, and then, yeah.
Because you both have been playing football for most of your lives, how do you think it's impacted who you became now?
It gave me a lot of character, showed how to work through things.
It impacted my life a lot. Showed me around the world, showed me a lot of friends, new people.
With a new coach this year, how do you think it affected this season?
It affected our season, bringing in a new coaching staff, bringing in new plays, bringing in people we wasn't comfortable around, we didn't really know as much. So, like, when Adams left, a lot of new things changed, and it's hard to make a change in 1 year.
What was the most fun part about this season?
Definitely being LP, homecoming. That's the felt top of the world, even though it was our first win, but felt great.
Yeah, LP was fun, but I gotta say the funnest was when we had a lock-in and we stayed overnight. We all had a team bonding moment, and it was really fun.
What's one thing you want to leave behind for the next team?
Definitely leadership. I hope that carries on to the juniors this year. I hope I taught them something, and I hope they stick with it.
Definitely just have fun and just play when you can play and do everything you can do.
As seniors, do you feel like you both did a good job leading the team?
I wish I did a little better, but yes, I think I did. But
I could say I did a good job leading the team, but I would be lying. But I did kind of lead the team at the beginning, but at the end, when the injuries started coming, I just backed up.
So for this being your guys' last season, is there anything else you'd like to say about Wyandotte football?
Wyandotte football always been amazing. I came here to play football, and it just treated me right. Nothing else has changed. Just a new coaching staff. But if we just play like we used to play, then Wyandotte football would be back on top.
Bear for life.
The football team didn't do as well as they wanted to this season, but me, Cody, and the rest of the student section had a fun time cheering them on this year.
The underclassmen will work hard to try and come back next season.
On the other side of the spectrum, our swim team brought home a league title. Malik got to talk to one of our seniors about this great season.
With one of our varsity swimmers, Kylie King. The girls performed so great this season. And Kylie, I just have a few questions to ask you. So, this year being so successful, your senior year, do you think this year you just brought a different level of intensity?
I feel like our upcoming class of freshmen this year definitely had a great level of like intensity for the year, because we had very strong underclassmen. So the fact that we had all those freshmen coming up definitely had part in our success this year.
How long have you swam, and what does it feel like knowing you're going to walk away?
Oh, I've swam since summer of fifth grade going into sixth grade, so I've swam for a while. My family's always been in the pool, so it's going to be a little different stepping away from the pool and kind of saying goodbye. I'll definitely miss it, but I'll be around because I have family swimming, so it's different not being on the deck, but I'll be happy to like be there and support the girls anytime they need me to or come back and visit.
How has swim like developed you as a person, you know? Like, this is a good program, and you got to be a part of it. Like,
It's definitely been a huge part of my life, especially for how long it's been in my life. Like I said, my parents were swimmers, and it's been in my family for a really long time. So I feel like just growing up around the water has definitely made me, like, a better person. Like, it's made me more aware.
2022 girls swim team had a phenomenal season this year with many monumental accomplishments, such as an undefeated season, a league title, and many historic wins. The team's first milestone this season was beating Trenton for the first time. They didn't just win, they won decisively 112-72.5. Being on the team for the past 2 years and losing to Trenton, how is this win so significant?
I never honestly really thought that we'd be able to beat them. I think that it's just a really big accomplishment, especially for our seniors, being able to say that they did that before, you know, they aren't on the team anymore.
This win was a catalyst for the rest of the season. Another big win came against Carlson, and again they won decisively. One highlight was the freshman Paula Negret, who broke multiple freshman records throughout the season, including the 500 freestyle, the 200 freestyle, the 100 freestyle, and the 100 fly.
Being in high school, does the competition get harder, and how do you feel you adjusted to that?
Competition did get harder, and I just, I've been used to swimming with a lot of faster people, so it was really kind of comforting and wasn't really a big difference that I didn't like.
Throughout the season, the team kept getting better, setting personal best and breaking pool records wherever they swam. Heading into the league meet, the team was undefeated and league championships was in sight.
At what point did you feel their undefeated record was at risk?
Probably the Carlson meet, I would say, just because they were ranked second at the time of the league. So going into it, I think everyone was really, not nervous, but just kind of more excited because it was going to be a good competition.
Our Lady Bears didn't stop there. At the qualifying league meet, the entire team qualified for the finals. The team won the league meet again quite decisively, scoring 582.5, with the next closest team, Allen Park, scoring 467.
How does it feel to be a part of such a history-making team?
It feels absolutely amazing, really. I'm so glad that I could help my team throughout the season and stuff. I was really excited going into the season because I knew it was going to be amazing, and I'm so glad it turned out the way it did.
This dominating team only had four seniors: Kylie King, Sam Koss, Katie Koss, and Scotland Vaughn. What legacy do you and the rest of the seniors leave for the RHS girls swim team?
I'm really grateful because this year we got to kind of make history with the team. We have went undefeated for the first time in Bears girls swim history. And so kind of being a part of that, I think, has been really great. And hopefully us seniors can be known as the seniors that led the team to victory.
So me and the rest of the seniors, we're leaving a legacy of winning DRC and leagues and beating both Trenton and Carlson at our dual meet and just staying on top.
Do you think this year set a standard for the program? Like, I mean, this was an amazing year by you girls.
I don't really feel like it set a standard. I feel like it just shows that, like, it just, because we've done so well this year, we're getting a lot more attention. Swim doesn't really get a lot of attention. People don't really know about it. And I feel like because of how much success we've gotten this year, I feel like it'll get more attention, and that'll be really nice because it's nice to feel appreciated in any sport. So with the success this year, I'm hoping for more attention in the future for the girls.
Now, Kylie, we know the team has done so well, but is there anything you realized, you wish you realized earlier as a swimmer that would have made you just a little better, quicker?
I wish I realized, like, there's not really, like, you're going to have those good days and you're going to have those bad days. So it's like, if you have one bad meet or one bad practice, like, that's not the end of it. Like, you have to, it's a really mental thing, so you just have to keep pushing through, because if you think you're gonna, like, you did bad in one race and you have another race coming up, you're gonna feel like you're gonna do bad in that other race too. So after you do bad in one race, like, you have to keep going. You can't stop it there.
And just such a great season. And you as a senior, and talking about that freshman and the underclassmen and how well they've performed, how have you impacted them just as a leader?
Oh, as a leader, I've been trying to keep them motivated. They've also motivated me. I feel that having such a strong team has made such a great relationship. And I feel that we've been able to bounce motivation off of each other. We keep each other high. And that has definitely helped with success in our season.
Do you think, like, a sisterhood almost has been created? Like, such a successful season and working together and going so far, like, the whole school is proud of you guys.
Yes, we definitely feel like a family. I feel like this is probably the closest team we've had. I feel that in past years, there has been a separation between like old team and new team. So I feel that we, like a lot of our success has had to do with like our family, our sisterhood, our bond.
Now last thing, what's your favorite memory in all of swimming, and what's your favorite memory from this season?
Ooh, in all of swimming, I think probably winning leagues and beating Trenton. That has to do with this year and all of swimming. Those are some of the most rewarding experiences I've had, and I'm very lucky to say that I was a part of a team that was able to win leagues and beat Trenton, our rivals.
And I'm very proud to say that I'm speaking with the swimmer who made T-Town go down.
The swim team had almost 30 members on the team, but this year's golf team was small with only 6 girls on the team, but they had a great time this season.
Here's Lauren with more on this
team. The girls' golf team record was 5-7. Let's go take a deeper look on their season. Who led the team this year?
Michaela Calhoun.
We didn't really have a specific leader. If I had to pick one, it would definitely be Michaela.
Me, because I'm the number one spot on the team and I play all the ones.
Michaela Calhoun.
What was your favorite part of the season's practices, because we're goofy?
Definitely like just being with my teammates.
Just to get to know all the new girls and the incoming freshmen.
I just like the practices and talking.
What was your favorite match?
My favorite match are the ones that we play at Wyandotte, just any of those, because it's at home.
The Southwinds. My regionals, because I played by myself this year and it was just fun to just go out there.
The Taylor match, because I had my best score.
What match did you do best at?
I would say I did about the same at all matches.
Second Southwinds match we had. The regionals, I played my best and it was just ultimately fun.
The Taylor one.
Who's the captain of the team?
It's Michaela Calhoun.
We don't really have a captain. It's basically, we all kind of work together as a team. We just have fun.
I'd say the captains are me and Grace. We kind of just hold the team together.
I'm Michaela Calhoun because she's the best on the team.
What's one thing you wish you did differently this season?
I wish I could have been more present.
I wish I kind of figured out how to improve my strokes.
Time in the season, because it kind of just goes by quick.
Not get mad at myself.
Who is the most improved?
The most improved was probably Violet Mickle.
Violet, because she ended up beating Michaela by one stroke on our final tournament.
The most improved award went to Violet.
Probably me, because I haven't really played before.
What's your guys' record?
Our record is 5-7.
It's 5-7.
Good job this season. Sounds like you guys had a lot of fun.
The girls' golf team ended their season 5-7. On the other hand, with a three-peat for both league and regional titles, was our boys' tennis team.
Boys' varsity tennis team finished first in the league this year, going 10-0 with only one tied match and no losses for their overall season, including 6 league wins, which earned them the league title.
What was your most challenging match of the season?
I have to say Troy, Ann Arbor, they were like pretty good, but we still won.
For me personally, probably playing like Divine Child and Dearborn, because those are the two matches I lost this season.
A Chelsea match, because they're just so good.
This season's all-league players were Emmett Oswald and Brendan Bayon, who both played singles, and Cole Bobian and Daniel Hickey, and Gavin Dom and Aiden Kuzma, who played doubles.
Who is the most consistent on the team?
Probably my trustworthy partner, Cole Bobian. He's just a fantastic tennis player.
Probably me.
Emmett Oswald. It's probably because he's singles one, so he's our best player.
Emmett Oswald or Daniel Hickey.
The team also took first place at regionals and brought home the regional title, which advanced the entire team to compete at the state finals.
What's been the standout of your season?
Winning regionals.
Us going to states and regionals.
Winning regionals.
They did not make it past the first round at states, but sophomore Brooks Blackledge won his singles match at states, earning the team some points. This year's varsity team kept the boys' tennis program's winning streak going by making it the third year in a row of being league and regional champions.
Have you guys managed to win regionals 3 years in a row?
Probably because of our coach, Joey Lazelle.
We had a pretty good coach. I mean, our coach kind of helped us all through it.
We're just that good.
Joey Lozell, best coach.
Congrats
Gavin
on the
Gavin Dom and Jack Maduba, who are the seniors and captains of our varsity boys tennis team. So, as captains of the team, what was the biggest challenge?
What was the biggest challenge this year, Gavin?
Keeping our boys in line and making sure they don't fool around at practice.
Yeah, that.
Fair. What was the biggest reward as the main leaders of your team?
Honestly, just seeing everyone do well at leagues and regionals was honestly the best reward that we could have gotten.
What was the highlight of your season?
The highlight of my season?
Definitely leagues and regionals, because we just got to three-peat, and it was very enjoyable.
Yeah, I know. That was a super fun time. And then that's when we found out we were going to go to States, so it was just super exciting.
Everyone knows you guys won three consecutive championships in a row. At the start of your season, did you think that this would happen?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I honestly knew that we were going to win leagues and regionals, and we were going to go to States. I just had a feeling.
We were very confident in our team this year.
Throughout the regular season, what was the most memorable match?
I think Trenton was the most memorable match because, personally, I lost to the kid after I beat him, and we tied with them, so it was just... Like in the regular season match, we tied with them. So it just kind of raised the stakes a little bit for leagues and regionals.
It was great to beat them in leagues and regionals because we lost to them in the regular season match. So,
once you won leagues, what was your coach's expectations for the rest of the season?
Just try our hardest. Don't give up. Keep playing how we're playing.
Yeah, that's basically what he said. He just said keep playing how you've been playing and just to keep up the good work for the rest of the season and do what we came here to do.
What was the most memorable part of the regional tournament?
The most memorable part of the regional tournament was when Gavin brought his cat ears and his cat nose, and we raced on all fours while, who was still playing?
Bayon was playing.
Yeah, Bayon was still playing. We were racing on all fours next to his court.
That was pretty awesome.
Who won?
Oh, Gavin did.
Yeah, I'm a good kid.
At States, there's a whole different type of competition, so tell me about that.
Yeah, they're really good. I got ripped up so bad, like I lost 0-6, 0-6, so that means they won every single match on me.
Yeah, we kind of knew that we were gonna get messed up at States, but we were just there to have fun, hang out with the team, because at least we won regionals three times in a row.
Yeah,
competition there is just very
different. A lot of the schools are rich schools, and these kids have been playing tennis for their whole lives, and a lot of them don't play other sports like me and Gavin do, so they're just focusing on tennis 24/7. So it's just different.
What's something that you want to leave behind for your teammates who are not graduating this year?
I just want to leave behind the legacy of just having fun, honestly, just making it your own game, and to just enjoy every practice, work your hardest at every practice, and just to have fun.
Yeah, coming to practice and having fun every day, which is what we do to make tennis so fun at our school. We just enjoy the practice and not take it as serious. Well, we still take it serious, but
try to
have as much fun as possible.
Yeah, and if you mess up or you don't do well one day, then it's just one day and you have all the rest of the season to get back up to your standards and stuff like that.
Thank you, guys. Well, if you guys see them in the halls at any point in time, tell them congratulations on their amazing season this year.
And underclassmen, join tennis next
join
season.
Join tennis
team definitely had a lot of fun this season, along with all of their success.
Another group of boys who had a lot of fun this season was our soccer team. They took a few hard losses this year, but overall had 9 wins, 4 losses, and 7 ties.
Carter spoke to some of the team about their season.
Good afternoon, RHS. I'm Carter Halberstadt with your YTV News, and soccer season just came to the end. Let's go take a look at how they did.
What are your personal highs and lows of the season?
My low was definitely hurting my knee, like, during mid-season, and then having to, like, I played a lot scared, and it really affected my gameplay.
I think my high was definitely when I played that defender position at Trenton. That was one of my best games, and I think a low for me was probably the tough loss against Woodhaven. I was in net for that one. I was a goalie, so it was very... I'm not usually a goalie, so it was very a tough task for me, but I think I performed well and did the best I could.
I'd probably say just the end of it was really fun. Was probably the high. The low was definitely like somewhere right for Trenton. We lost, or we tied 4-4. It was a difficult tie.
What did you as a team do well?
I think we communicated very well. You know, we're a family, and there's definitely no I in team. So as much as, like, everyone wants to do it by themselves, like, it's a team sport. So when we all work together, we got the job done. We got a lot of wins this season.
We had a really good chemistry together. We were all kind of really good friends.
What position are you, and what does it do?
I play mid, and it controls the tempo of the game.
I'm a center back. I just play defense right in the middle.
I'm mainly a defender. I played every year this year. But as a defender, they just stop the strikers from getting close to our goalie and scoring the goals.
Wow, that looked like a really great season. Anyways, I'm Carter Halberstadt with the RHS TV News. Now back to the anchors.
14 seniors on this year's soccer team who will all miss the sports that they love.
There were only 2 seniors on the volleyball team, but similar to soccer, they love their sport, and both of them have been playing since 7th grade.
Hello there, RHS. I'm Malik Hillier, and today I'm here with your senior volleyball players.
Madison Russell.
Brooke Geiser.
Now, ladies, even though you didn't have the season you sought out to have, how do you feel this season's developed you as a person?
I feel like being on the volleyball team really helped me develop leadership skills. Being a part of a team where a lot of girls, like, were hurt in the middle of the season, like, we really had to rally together, and I feel like creating, like, a culture where everybody tries their hardest is, like, really important, but it's also really fun.
How long have you guys played volleyball, and do you still see it in your future?
Since 6th grade, and probably now.
Yeah, I've been playing since 6th grade, and I definitely love to play, but I don't think it's for me later on.
How does it feel that you're going to have to walk away from the game?
I honestly think it's pretty sad. It's sad to see it go.
Do you think anything this year you've done as seniors has helped underclassmen, and do you see a brighter future for the program?
I definitely think that training with the JV and freshman teams helped them develop skills, like, earlier on, just to get a little head start. But I do see, like, a bright future for the program.
Is there anything you wish you realized earlier as a volleyball player that would have just helped you this senior year and maybe earlier years?
Not to be scared to do something.
Yeah, just to throw it all on the court.
This being your senior year, did you just come at it with a different level of intensity?
Yeah,
I'd say so.
Now, how do you guys just feel in general about this season? Even if it didn't go the way you liked, do you still have fond memories of it? Will this be a fond memory?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
What do you guys say is your favorite volleyball moment of all time?
Double days driving around in my car.
Yeah.
And getting lunch.
Double days doing what?
Like, getting lunch. Like, we would have breaks in between, like, our double practice days, like, during, like, the summer.
Four-hour practices.
But in between, we'd have, like, little hour breaks to eat lunch, and we'd drive around in my car.
Being the seniors this year, how is it different that now you guys are the top dogs and you guys used to look up to the top dogs? What's the difference finally being in that position?
It's kind of weird. I still don't see myself as a senior, so it's just kind of surreal.
And that's all here with our senior volleyball players. We're so proud of these ladies. If you see them in the hallway, tell them congratulations, and you wish them the best luck.
These 2 senior athletes are done with their high school career, as are Sam Cost and Michael McCooch, who were standouts on this year's cross-country team.
Carlos talked to the runners about their season.
This year's cross-country teams did very well. The boys placed 3rd in the league, with senior Michael McCooch taking the league title individually.
A lot of consistent training, a lot of miles, long runs, workouts on the track, so a lot of stuff with the team.
Michael recently had a race at Milan Speedway, where he placed 101st at states. He also had a race at regionals where he placed 5th with a personal best time of 16.4.
Now at regionals, you can't do anything before the race to get any better. So it's really all about showing everybody what you can do. So just racing hard, doing your best.
The girls team was on top of the Downriver League, finishing 1st at league meet. Individually, Sam Cost won the league with Lauren Merlo, Eleanor Grant, Mercedes Jingle, and Abby Caudelli, all finishing in the top 20.
I think one factor has probably been consistency and hard work and just training every day.
At regionals, despite saving 31 seconds, Sam Cost finished 4th, and freshman Eleanor Grant finished 22nd, both qualifying for states.
I was pretty excited. I was coming down the finish, and I saw the time, and I knew it was definitely going to be pretty quick, and I just crossed the line and was so excited.
Sam Cost finished 45th. At states, and throughout the season, she cut a total of 54 seconds off her time. The boys and the girls cross country team had an amazing season, led by seniors Michael McCooch and Sam Cost.
The fall sports athletes have finished their season, while others are preparing to move on to their next sport.
The fall sports season at RHS was filled with some impressive accomplishments. including a tennis three-peat, a regional championship, and a swimming undefeated season.
As we move into winter sports, we hope our winning athletes can be as successful in their seasons.
Thank you for tuning in to our fall sports recap. Keep working hard, Bears.
And with that, the 2022 season comes to an end. Good night.
There's been so many things that's held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end